Good morning, students. Once again, a very warm welcome to the English world of Aaradhya. Myself, Rashmin sir, imparting the knowledge of English to the students of 9th to 12th standard in English medium. Students, today we will learn your second poem. The title of the poem is The Lebanon Top. It is written by Ted Hughes. Okay. So, what is this Lebanon, students? Actually, Lebanon is the name of a tree. Okay. It has hanging branches. It has some yellow colored flowers and its seeds are very poisonous. So it is about this particular tree and also what happens on this tree. Okay, poem is very short one, but it gives us the idea that how important is the protection of parents for the children. Okay. Nobody, not a single child would just imagine herself to be or himself to be an orphan, because they require in their young days, they require, and I say lifelong, they require the protection of parents. Later on, they may not require protection, but guidance of the parents also they require. So here this particular poem gives us that sort of message. I'll read out the poem so that you can understand it in a better way. The laburnum top is silent, quite still. In the afternoon yellow September sunlight, a few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. Then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness. And a machine starts up of chitterings and a tremor of wings and trillings. The whole tree trembles and thrills. It is the engine of her family. She stokes it full, then floods out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. Then with airy delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite and the laburnum subsides to empty. Okay, students, so here your poem ends. I hope you have understood at least some part of it. Here we are made aware about two different things. One is about the tree and the other is about one particular bird. The name of the bird over here is goldfinch. Okay, before we go into that, I will just explain to you the poem line wise. First line, the laburnum top is silent, quite still. So if you look at the top part of the laburnum tree, how it looks? It looks very quiet. Okay, nothing is there at the top. Okay, it looks very quiet, very silent. In the afternoon yellow September sunlight. So the time mentioned over here is the September month. Okay, and it is during the day, sunlight means during the day. Okay, and it is also considered as an autumn season, because in autumn seasons only the leaves become yellow and they fall and the seeds also fall. So that is mentioned in the third line. A few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. So from that we can make out that it is the autumn season. That's why the tree's leaves are yellowing. Okay, then what happens? Second stanza, till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup. Students, later on I'll show you the picture of goldfinch. For the time being, you just understand that the meaning is given at the bottom. Goldfinch is a small singing bird with yellow feathers on its wings. But there are these goldfinch of different colors also. Many have red colors, green color, like those. But here they are talking about the goldfinch which are having yellow feathers. Okay, I'll show you the picture of it in the course of this explanation. A suddenness, so the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup. Okay, when it comes, it makes some sound. Chirrup means some sound over here of goldfinch. Okay, so it makes a twitching sound over there. A suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. So when it comes, it lights on the end of the branch. So on the end of the branch you find what? Some sort of suddenness, some sort of startlement means surprise. Okay, at the branch end. Then sleek as a lizard. So here goldfinch is compared with a lizard. As lizard is very sleek, okay, sleek means smooth. So this goldfinch is also very smooth. But you must have noticed that lizard is very alert also, okay, and very abrupt also. So similarly, this goldfinch also is very alert. She is also very abrupt over here. Okay, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up. So now from branch end, she goes inside towards the trunk side. Why? That is not mentioned. We will come to know in the course of time. Okay, then she enters the thickness. Thickness means the thick part of the tree towards the trunk side. Okay, middle part of the and a machine starts up. When she goes towards that side, a machine starts up. Here machine is none other but her young ones. Okay, baby goldfinch, we can say. So there are many baby goldfinches. So as soon as they see their mother, they start chirping. Ki mummy aa gayi, mummy aa gayi. Up till now they were quiet. As soon as they see the parents here, mother, okay, mother goldfinch, they all just start chirping like an engine, so like a machine. So all the young ones of goldfinch are compared with a machine, remember. Of chitterings, so they make that chittering sound, and a tremor of wings. They have not just learnt flying yet, because they have not got the wings, only minor wings, but that also they try to what, just flap their wings, okay. So their tremor of the wings also can be heard, and trillings. Trilling is also again you see a sound, trembling sound. So all those sounds are produced by her young ones. The whole tree trembles and thrills. Initially the entire tree was quiet, but when the mother goldfinch came, these all the young ones, they start making different sounds. So it seems that the whole tree is trembling, okay, whole tree is getting thrilled, excite ho chuki hai, excite hue hai, sirf bacche hi excite hue hai, but it seems that the whole tree has got thrilled. Okay, it is the engine of her family. So why they have got thrilled? Because it is here means the goldfinch, that bird, it is the engine of her family. Without engine, the train cannot go ahead. So if these children, if these offsprings of goldfinch, if they want to grow up, they will require to be fed. And who would feed them? Mother goldfinch only will feed them. So mother goldfinch has come with some food, and now she is going to feed the young ones. Understood? So that's why mother goldfinch is known as, is compared with an engine. She is the engine of her family. She stokes it full, yani she just feeds them fully, okay. Stokes means to add fuel. So here it is said that she stokes them full, yani she feeds her young ones fully. Then floats out to a branch end. Then she walks out, moves out quickly to the branch end. Because after feeding those children, now the young ones of goldfinch will sleep. They have had enough food. So they will sleep now. So mother can go out for in search of some other thing, some food or something. So that's why she now moves out to the branch end. Remember when she came, to from down or from the outside we can see only her back part. But when she comes out from the middle of the tree, that time we can see her face down, because now she is coming outwards. Okay. So while coming outwards, what happens? Floats out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. So students, here you'll have to be very careful about this particular line. When she comes out, she shows her barred face identity mask. It means she is just showing her face to us, but her face is what? Her face is covered with different types of colors. And that's why it is said that usne mask pehna hai aisa lagta hai. Actually she has got natural colors on her face, okay, in the form of some stripes. But here it seems that she has, her face is covered with a mask. You can just look at these pictures, students, okay. Is it clear? So here you see there all the goldfinch, so many are there, and their faces are covered with different stripes, maybe black colored, red colored, like that. So it seems that they have put on some mask. This, when the goldfinch came, that time we could not notice, but now when she comes out from the branch side, so we can notice that her face is like that. It seems to be covered with some mask. So while she comes out, that time only we can see her real face. Okay, then with airy delicate whistle, chirrups, whispering, she launches away. Now she knows that her young ones are sleeping. So now with very much delicacy, without making any sound, okay, she is just airy delicate, means very light movement. She doesn't want her young ones to get up. So with light movement, she just goes away from there. Whistle, chirrup. Whistling, whistle sounds is producing just to make her young ones sleep. Okay? Whispering also is a sound. With that sound, then she launches away towards the infinite, towards the sky. Sky is considered as infinite. So now she flies away towards the infinite, launches away means. And the labanum subsides to empty. And once again you find the labanum tree very empty, because no more movement is there, no more sound is there. So initially when the poem began, labanum was empty, still. And in the end of the poem also, when the goldfinch goes away, that time again it becomes empty, still, quiet. Understood? With that we complete the poem. Now students, we will look at the question answers of this particular poem. Your first question is, what do you notice about the beginning and end of the poem? So in the beginning also the labanum tree is quiet. In the end, when the goldfinch goes away towards the sky after feeding her young ones, that time again it becomes quiet. So this is the common thing that we notice in the beginning and in the end of the poem. Second question, to what is the bird's movement compared? What is the basis for the comparison? So the bird's movement is compared with that of lizard. Just as lizard is sleek, goldfinch is also sleek. Just lizard is alert, goldfinch is also alert. Just lizard is very abrupt, the goldfinch is also abrupt. So all those things are the basis of this comparison. Okay, why is the image of engine evoked by the poet? So as I told you while explanation, without engine the train cannot move. So here engine will run on the fuel, and that fuel will help the entire train to run. So students, here also you see the goldfinch is the engine of her family. If she does not feed her young ones would not grow up. So that fuel feeding part is done by goldfinch. That's why goldfinch is compared with an engine. Okay? Then, what do you like the most about the poem? Okay? So here you see that is up to you students, like that question won't be asked, but whatever you have liked, you can just talk about that. I already told you, okay, without protection of the parents, the children try to just grow in sociable manner, okay? So here, that is the best part, parents taking care of their children. What does the phrase, her barred face identity mask mean? So the goldfinch has those stripes on her face, and that's why it seems that she has covered her face with some mask. Understood? So we mean that when she comes out, it seems that she is coming out wearing the mask. Actually it is not a mask, it is they are the natural bars on her face. Okay, so while going, her face could not be seen because she was making the movement that side. When she comes out, she is making the movement towards outside. So that's why we can see her face. And those bars on her face are natural. It is not a mask, but we can imagine them to be a mask. Okay? So with that, students, question answers are over. Now I'll quickly look at the figures of speech. The labanum top is silent, quite still. So you see, labanum top is given the quality of being silent. So you can say it is personification, and silent and quite still, both the words silent and still means the same. So it is tautology also. In the afternoon, yellow September sunlight. Okay, so September and sunlight, students, you see S sound is repeated, so it is alliteration, and it also refers to. Okay, next line we will see. Few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. So now leaves and seeds are the parts of a laburnum tree. So you can say it is synecdoche. And those two things suggest that it is an autumn season. So you can say it is metonymy also. Okay. A few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. Okay. Then there is no other figure of speech in that. Then we come to the second stanza. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup. So chirrup is a sound produced by goldfinch. So you can say it is what? It is onomatopoeia. Twitching chirrup sound. That is onomatopoeia. A suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. So suddenness and startlement. That is S sound is repeated. So it is what? It is alliteration. Then, sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt. So, here goldfinch is compared with lizard with the word as. So, it is simile. Okay. And there is also alliteration because alert and abrupt and end. So, it is A sound is repeated in that entire line as, and, alert and abrupt. So, A sound is repeated so many times, so it is alliteration. End is repeated twice, so it is repetition also. Okay. She enters the thickness and a machine starts up. She enters the thickness. Here, thickness stands for the middle part of the tree. So, it is metonymy. And machine, that you can say, the young ones of goldfinch are compared with a machine. So, it is metaphor. A machine means who? A machine represents the young ones of the goldfinch. So it is metonymy also and metaphor also. Okay. Then of chittering and a tremor of wings and trillings. So all these are the three sounds. Okay. So it is onomatopoeia. And T is repeated through the words, T sound is repeated through the words tremor and trilling. So it is alliteration also, students. So it is both onomatopoeia and alliteration. Okay. The whole tree trembles and thrills. So again T sound is repeated through the words tree and trembles. So it is alliteration. Okay. And the whole tree trembles and thrills. But the root part, trunk part of the tree may not tremble. So students, it is hyperbole. Thoda jyada bol diya hai. Understood? So it is hyperbole also. Whole tree is just given that quality, it is alliteration also, and tree is given the quality of trembling, thrilling. Thrilling means getting excited, so it is personification. Okay, she, it is the engine of her family. Now it means goldfinch is give, directly compared with engine, so it is metaphor. Next line, she stokes it full and then flirts out to a branch end. So two different actions are taking place one after the other. She is first feeding its family and then she goes out. So it is climax. She and Stokes. So S sound is produced those two with this, those two words. F sound is also produced with the words full and floods. So it can be alliteration also. It is alliteration. Showing her barred face identity mask. So here the goldfinch is showing us the her barred face identity mask. It means her face. That thing refers to her face. So it is metonymy. Okay. Then, students, in the next line you see, then with airy delicate whistle chirrup whispering. So whistle chirrup whispering, all these three are sound. So it is onomatopoeia. Understood? She launches away towards the infinite. She launches away. Yani she just moves away, flies away. And towards the infinite. Here infinite refers to the sky. So it is metonymy. Understood? And the last line, and the laburnum subsides to empty. So laburnum again becomes calm, silent. So laburnum tree is given the quality of becoming silent. So it is personification. Understood? So students, with that we come to the end of this wonderful poem. It is a short poem, but quite interesting enough. I hope you have understood the poem, you have also understood the question answers and figures of speech. Kindly just repeat it once for your own knowledge. Thank you and have a nice day.